Now see, as we have done with the practical, that is, we have done with our procedure, right? Now what the thing you have to write is the observation and the readings, right? So as I have told you before, that the mass of the hanger is about 500 gram. Then the total mass with the the slotted weights, it is about 2500 gram. Okay, so we have to calculate the tension applied to the wire. It is about 2.45 into 10 to the power 5 dyne. Okay, so now as I was doing the practical, I have written the experiment. The readings of each tuning fork. Okay, that is 512. We have got the vibrating length as 16.5. So twicer I have checked it and I got it again 16.5. So therefore the mean length is about 16.5. Same for the 426 is about 20 centimeter. Then 384 it is about 22.2. 341.3 it is about 24.5 centimeter. Then I have done with the mean length. Okay, then we have taken 480 as unknown frequency. Okay, again I am going to tell you that in exam this 480 will be covered by some sellotape. Okay, so that it is been looking as its unknown frequency only. So therefore this thing you have to not write over here when you are actually writing the practical. Okay, so the unknown frequency, we got the length as 17.5. okay, then this length is called as L dash. Okay, now I have taken the reciprocal of the mean length. Okay, so the reciprocal of the mean length, you can take it as, I'll just show you once, do not use the calculator for these things. Okay, you have to go through the log table only, because in exam calculator is not been allowed for you, so you have to do the practice for log tables. Okay, once I'll just show you the one first reading, how to take the reciprocal using the log table. So what is our length? It is 16.5. okay, so in your textbook only you have the column at the end, reciprocal. See, these are the square roots. These are the squares. Squares are also available. This is the part called as what? Reciprocal. This is starting from 5.5. We'll just go to 16.5. Okay, I'll just show you 16.5. See, this is the reciprocal which is starting from 0.1. Okay, this is the four digit number. Okay, so what was our length? We was having for 512. This is the frequency for 512. The vibrating length we got 16.5 centimeter. This was hertz. Okay, so what you have to find out? You have to find out the reciprocal of this one. Okay, so the reciprocal of 1 upon 16.5. If you look at this, these first two table. Okay, first two numbers are being taken from this vertical column. And the third number or fourth number has been taken from this horizontal column. Okay, now what the thing is, we have 16.5. okay, and over here if you see, these numbers are having the decimal point after first digit number, that is, it is 2 point, then 3 point, then 4 point, then 5 point, and then 6 point. Okay, so 6 point is over here. We are having 16, right? So 16 will come at what place? It is about here. But this is not 16, this is 1.6, and what we got is 16, right? So we have to convert this 16 into 1.65. But while converting, you have to not at all change the significant number. Okay, the significance of this will be remaining same. Just you have to write this 16.5 in the other method. Okay, so how can you write? It will be in this way. Can I write like this? 16.5 into 10 divided by 10. So what I am doing? I am multiplying and dividing by 10. Okay, by doing this, this number will be as it is. I am not changing the number. Okay, only this much if you do, then your number gets changed. The original number gets changed. So therefore you don't have to change the number, you have to just change the method of writing this number. Okay, so what I am doing, I am just applying this to this. So how much it will be? No, I'm just using the numerator for this one. So how much it will be? By using the numerator, it will be how much? It will be 1.65 into 1 upon 10. I'm not using the denominator. If I use the denominator, it will be 165. So I don't want 165. I want 1.6. Right? So I have used the numerator 10 and multiplied to this. Then I got 1.65. Okay? Now, what the thing, you have to keep this as it is. Take the reciprocal of this. Now, this 1 upon 1.65, it is here. So, no need to write after doing this calculation, no need to write the answer in 1 upon. Okay, fraction mein nahi likhna hai aapko. Kyunki ye reciprocal hi hai. Already this is reciprocal. That means 1 upon something number. Okay. So 1.65 it is there. Okay. So 1.6 is over here. And 5 you have to take it from here. Okay. So 1.6 come downward in the line of 1.6 and you get the answer as 6061. Now have a look at this first column. It is about 0.5, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.1. Okay, 1 point. Then 0.9. So that means what? These all numbers are in 0 point something. Okay. So these, yahan pe agar point nahi likha, iska matlab ye nahi hai ki yahan pe point hai nahi. They have written the common point. Okay, common point yahan pe likha hai, iska matlab sabko hai. So therefore this much, this will be 0.6061. So how much it is? Yes, iska reciprocal ka kitna nikla hamara? 0.6061 itna nikla hai. Okay, abhi to ye hua nahi. Abhi aapko kya karna hai? Isko 1 upon 10 se multiply karna hai. Agar ye 1 upon 10 aap bhul gaye, iska matlab aapne ye number change karwa diya. हमने चेंज किया क्या? नहीं, हमने ये दोनों 10 यूज किए हैं. ओके, सो देयरफॉर व्हाट ये जो है नीचे है, तो अगर हमने ऊपर इसको भेजा तो इसका जो पावर है ये माइनस में हो जाएगा, है ना. तो दूसरी साइड हम लोग भेज रहे, सो इट विल बी अबाउट 10 टू द पावर माइनस 1. नाउ इफ आई डू दिस, ओके, इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई दिस टू दिस, देन इट विल बी 0.06061. ओके, सो दिस इज योर रेसिप्रोकल. Okay, this is your reciprocals. So this is the method to find out the reciprocals of any number. This method will be helpful for you for finding the numbers which are in reciprocals. Okay, so this is the thing. If you want to check this answer is right or wrong, you just cross check from your calculator, you will get the same answer. Okay, so I have used only what the first three numbers I have used. Okay, 6-1 I have not written in my book. Okay, so don't make a confusion. I have just written the point ke baad ke maine three numbers likhe hai. Okay, then I have completed this table. The same thing you have to do for the unknown frequency also. Okay, but because this we are needing this. Okay, now the last column, NL. Okay, the last column calculation they have given you in this part. Okay, this is the table. Now what is this table tells you? Yes, this is log n, matlab ye aayega, iska log yahan pe likhna hai aapko. Then log of L, matlab iska length kitna hai? 16.5. 16.5 ka log table, log yahan pe likho. तब आपको क्या करना है, दोनों को ऐड करना है. दोनों को ऐड करो, फिर यहाँ पे आपको मिलेगा एंटी लॉग. ओके, यहाँ पे जो आंसर मिलेगा इसका एंटी लॉग लिखना है और यहाँ पे उसका आंसर आएगा. वैसे ही सेम आपको किसका करना है? ये चारों का करना है. पांचवें का नहीं करना, बिकॉज वी आर नॉट एट ऑल नोइंग द फ्रीक्वेंसी विच इज़ गिवन टू यू, बिकॉज दैट इज़ covered by sellotape. Okay, it will be covered by sellotape and therefore you are not knowing. So how you can know this unknown frequency? By doing the calculation. Okay, so therefore this fifth column is not there. Even here also you have to write dash, because NL यहाँ पे हमने calculation किया ही नहीं, क्योंकि हमको मालूम ही नहीं है frequency कितनी दी है. So यहाँ पे आपको dash लिखना है. ओके, एक बार आपने ये सारा calculation लिख दिया, आपको ये जो numbers यहाँ पे मिलेंगे NL के, ये आपको यहाँ पे लिखना है. ठीक है, एनएल लिखने के बाद आपको मीन वैल्यू निकालना है. मीन वैल्यू कैसे निकालते हैं? सबको ऐड करके डिवाइड बाय नंबर ऑफ रीडिंग्स. सो हाउ मेनी नंबर्स यू हैव टेकन? 4. सो देयरफॉर व्हाट यू विल राइट? 4 ओवर हियर. एंड आई गॉट 8,466.75. ओके, सो यहाँ पे मैं ये जो दो नंबर्स हूँ 75, आई जस्ट टेक द सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर्स. ओके, सो यहाँ पे मैं ये जो 7 है ये यहाँ पे ऐड कर दूंगी 1 यहाँ पे, तो ये बन जाएगा 7. सो आई हैव जस्ट टेकन इन दैट वे ओनली दिस. ओके, दिस इज एक्चुअली 7. सो आई हैव टू कैलकुलेट अननोन फ्रीक्वेंसी. अगेन दिस यू हैव टू डू इट बाय लॉग. ओके, लॉगरिथम मेथड यू हैव टू डू. सो log of 8467 divided by log of 17.5. now what is the 17.5? can you look here? it is l dash. over here also this is n dash and here you have got l dash. l dash kitna hai? 17.5 hai. to 17.5 yahan pe hai. आपको यहाँ पे 17. इसका मतलब ये डिवीजन है, इसका मतलब लॉग में ये माइनस हो जाता है. तो इसका लॉग और इसका लॉग आपको माइनस करना है. माइनस करने के बाद आप एंटी लॉग देखोगे. एंटी लॉग देखने के बाद आपको ये आंसर मिलेगा. पॉइंट में थोड़ा डिफरेंस होगा बट यू विल गेट द सेम आंसर 483.8. नाउ सी व्हाट आई हैव रिटन ओवर हियर 480 एंड आई हैव गॉट 483. सो इट इज़ ऑलमोस्ट यस नियरर टू द यस द स्टैंडर्ड वैल्यू. So this is my answer. This is my unknown frequency. Now this we have done by calculation method. Now here, if you see, I have drawn here on y-axis 1 upon L, which is in, yes, centimeter. And here I have drawn the frequency. Okay. Now what you have to do? You have to plot 1 upon L on y-axis and this frequency of tuning fork on x-axis. Okay. So I have plotted the points, 4 points. Okay. Now here you have to find out the unknown frequency. Now how to find out the unknown frequency? See, this is the unknown frequency, right? And we have found the unknown frequency length as 17.5, right? The vibrating length. Now if vibrating length is about 17.5, then what will be the reciprocal? It will be 0.057, as I have explained you about 0.060, right? That is 16.5. how to remove the reciprocal? In the same manner you have to remove it. Okay, now then if you found this 1 upon L of the unknown frequency, then what you have to do with that? 0.057 it is, right? So 0.057, it is over here, right? So from that point you have to draw a perpendicular line towards the straight line. Okay, this straight line should pass from the origin. Okay, now I have drawn the straight line and it has touched to the straight line. Oh, sorry, I have drawn a perpendicular line towards the straight line, right? Then again you have to draw a straight line from this position towards the x-axis. Okay, and at the x-axis you will get the unknown frequency. And how much it is, you have to calculate. Find out. It is this one is 450, then after two boxes it is 460, then after two boxes it is about 470, and it is in between 470 and 480. So how much it is? 475. So therefore the unknown frequency is 475. Okay, we'll tell you how is the graph. It is a straight line, right? So as I have shown you, it is a straight line. Okay, then unknown frequency of a tuning fork by calculation. So by calculation, how much we got? We got, yes, 483.8. So here you will write 483.8 hertz, and then you unknown frequency of a tuning fork by graph, how much we got? It is 475. See, 475. Okay, so 475 hertz we got. Okay, so this much is your practical, this much you have to perform. Scale you have to write it, then you have to write the unknown frequency in the graph, and then you have to complete the result, and then you have to write the precaution. Okay, see here, the paper rider should be always in the midway of the, yes, knife edges, that is bridge, I have told you, right? So this much is the practical. Okay.